This is the second half of the concert. We're going to start off with the apex of the evening. That's right, it's a raffle. We have a raffle that's going to be a little bit different. We're going to have a raffle that is for our Pops concert. Our Pops concert is, I believe, May 25th. It's going to be a celebration. Just a reminder, that concert will be a 6:30 start, because it tends to be a little bit longer, because we have a lot to celebrate, especially all our great seniors. So we will have a 6:30 performance time for that. Also, we have May 3rd, if you don't know, May 3rd is going to be our preliminary date for our Kiwanis solo competition. So that should have gone out in the email, mass email. So those are some things. And we also have some auditions coming up at some point for next year. So these are things that the students should be thinking about if they're not going on to bigger and better things. Well, you have a raffle here. We're gonna have some of our newbies here are gonna pick our winners. There are four choices. So if you are the first name on here, you get the first choice. The choices are, you can pick a song. Any song that you'd like within reason that we can arrange for the Pops concert. That's the first choice. So if you wanna bring Coachella here to Sam and I, we are guests. The second choice is, another choice is to have a piece performed by the Wind Symphony. The third choice is to play the cowbell in, seems to be a new tradition here, with Mr. Sacco's or cowbell piece. And the last one is to conduct a piece with the wind ensemble on a march. So those are the four choices. We're going to choose our four winners. And it'll go in order. If you're the first winner, you get the first choice. Second person gets the second choice. So let's have our first representative pick a name out and name it.
We have Amelia Hardisk. If you can't attend the spring concert, Felix.
Scheduling of the music, so there's definitely some repeat performances that you may have heard before, but we're going to start off with a piece called Bright Lights. It's very dandy, it's very fun, so enjoy.
Thank you.
two pieces that we performed on tour. The students performed so beautifully. We had an opportunity to perform at Sonoma State, an incredible performance hall up there. A lot of the bands that performed there brought their quote unquote top band. And it was so nice. We talked to the students about going there, and when you go on the state level, you're going to represent Samohai, and they're going to expect the best no matter what. And they performed beautifully, not only at the Harker School, but also in the festival performance. They got a great clinic from Professor Sedetal from Michigan State, and he had a lot of appreciation about not just playing notes, but playing music. He mentioned that our group was one of the few groups that day that were playing the music. They were playing musically, they were playing with emotion, and they know that that's kind of what I love to do. I love that, to shape music. And they did an incredible job on that tour. So we're going to perform for you two pieces. The last one we know really well, which is the Overture Candide, which is going to be celebrating Bernstein. But the piece before, you heard one of the pieces by this composer, John Mackey. This is his performed the piece called This Cruel Moon. If you have the program notes, go ahead and take a look at them at some point. But try to imagine a piece of music that really is about love that's not reciprocated. I used to love saying that word, and now I don't like saying that word as much. But the word, the love that's not reciprocated, and it's kind of telling the story of Odysseus, who, you know, has a great experience with someone for a while, and then just realizes, no, I want to go home, and just treats this other person with very little respect, and emotions are one way. In the program notes, it's much nicer than what I just said. So enjoy the program notes. Enjoy this. They played this so well. Maestro Wu, if you get a chance, go and watch her conduct this. It was so, so good. I will share one last thing. Mr. Soccer talked about student teaching here in Santa Monica, and Mina did an amazing job on that, on her conducting. She's going to do great things. And quick story, when I was first teaching, I got a job at John Adams Middle School, and then I left John Adams to go back to grad school. And I was in grad school, and I just remember this fear. I just gave up a great job in Santa Monica. And luckily, I was able to get back into this program, and I've loved every minute of the 17 years, and I'm looking forward to another 170. Okay.